Jace on the run, you know what I'm saying? We about to go to Couture Coffee Shop, you know what I mean? We got DTV coming through the building, Booza Babe coming through the building, you feel me? It's about to be real good show. Get into this real shit, you know how we do, on the run.
TV. I'm Charles.
It's Groove.
Booza Bang.
Yeah, we're gonna just get right into it today. Today we at Couture Coffee Shop.
Yeah, we at Couture Coffee Shop today
up in Fredericksburg. We're about to get into, you know, different topics. Go ahead.
So just gonna dive right into it.
So first thing we're gonna go into today is Jussie Smollett.
Oh, where those
vibes. Yeah.
Did you see that?
Yeah, man.
So a little bit of
like from the jump, I've been following.
For real?
Yeah.
Word. How did you feel?
Like just hearing about how he got messed up and it was a racial attack.
Yeah, that's what he said. He said it was a racial attack. You know, the people from like across the street and they were running. Running to go attack him. He was yelling like MAGA and shit. They had MAGA hats. So I think like basically he was trying to say like it was a racial attack by like people supporting that. You know what I mean?
Yeah, so he tried to make it seem like it was about the MAGA thing, you know, everything going on with Donald Trump. And then he also tried to throw in, you know, his homosexuality into it too.
Like a hate crime.
Yeah, like a hate crime. That's how he said it. So
what actually came out this week was everything he's saying is being debunked.
Okay.
It was no MAGA hats. That's what we know. It wasn't two white guys, it was two black guys that have some affiliation with him. I don't know. I heard reports saying, you know, it's There's reports saying he's on Empire and he's connected to them in some way.
Yeah.
Nobody knows yet, so I'm not gonna say that on camera, but
so was this for publicity or was this like to raise like political awareness towards, you know, like why did they stage stuff like that?
Shit, I'll
say clout.
Well, nah, actually, it's another report. I don't know this to be true, but he's about to get written off the show.
Oh, so maybe he needs some type of...
Yeah, it clout too. Like, then, you know, think about it. For somebody to just get thrown into a hate crime and then they write him off the show, they look crazy. So you gotta, like, keep him on there. But my issue is if he's lying, because we don't know yet, but it seems that way from everything that's going on.
Yeah.
It seems that way from everything that's going on. We got another guest. You can come on in too.
What's up?
We don't know what I'm saying.
Oh, yeah.
Venom, pull up.
Yeah,
pull up. You know what I'm saying?
Oh, you want to go in?
Pull up in. DTV, come in the building. You know what I'm saying? You got some guests pulling up. You feel me? Introduce yourself.
We definitely got it.
All right. Well, it's fine. It's fine. We came in deep though.
Oh, okay, so
you guys. Hey, where you been?
Yes. It was good.
All right. No, but I guess because y'all know. But I'm Eddie. I work for DTV, the label. I can be found at @Eddo_DTV. I got a clothing line, got some fashion shows coming up, but that's me, that's just one part of the company, so.
Word. What's up, bro?
What's good, y'all?
My man, Phantom.
You know what I'm saying? I'm Phantom with F. CEO of DTV Label. I should be looking at John, the camera.
There we go, man. Yo, conversation, man.
Plug yourself. You know what I'm saying?
Plug in.
CEO of DTV Label, Drink Team Vision LLC. One of the biggest startup companies out here. Rapidly growing, rapidly expanding, got a team full of leaders.
So before y'all came in, we were just talking about Jussie Smollett. Mm-hmm. And, you know, the lion, that's the legend, and legend lion.
Yeah,
we don't know that he's lying.
We heard lion was lying. He set it up. What y'all think about that whole situation?
See, but if you think that he would, all right, just hear me out with the situation. If you were to set yourself up to get jumped, you would make sure 100% that there was no way that they could find out.
To come back to you, unless you're a dumbass.
But like, he's got bread. He's on Empire. Like,
word.
He's paid.
But they said he was about to get written off, though. And so,
who
are
we talking about?
The dude from Empire.
The dude from Empire.
Oh, the brother.
Yeah, the singing dude.
He was singing.
Remember he got jumped. He
said the dudes was like yelling at us from across the street.
Like racial slurs.
And they came over
and we forgot the noose. He said they was walking
with a noose.
Walking away.
He said they put bleach on them too.
And like negative freezing below temperatures in Chicago.
Right. So unless it was a already pre-personalized attack, I mean,
I was. What I was,
points of deal is that you got a noose and bleach.
Word. Right. And they had MAGA hats on. Yeah. And they yelled out, "This."
That's pretty. That's pretty specific. And then followed by the letters that were sent to the to this house. Come on.
Yeah. I mean, shit. Anything is possible.
Anything is possible.
Especially in entertainment, that's
a fact.
That's how I look at it.
I mean, everybody doing publicity stunts right now.
Word, right. You never know.
I'm not gonna say he was lying. I'm not gonna say it was the truth. But what I will say is, regardless, I mean, it looks like a hate crime, and that's what should be what we're talking about.
So it's
about.
The point.
Word.
It's the point.
It's about the point.
Yeah, it's about the hate crime. It's not about the fact that it was him specifically. Word. It was the fact that it was a MAGA attack against a homosexual, openly gay man, and it seemed like it was targeted. That's the issue. That can even be connived into a story.
Word.
That's why.
I just look at it though, like as you know, a black man. Like I'm quite sure everybody out here has been profiled in some way.
Yeah.
You know that somebody that's out here just like fake jumping on the calls, and then you know it's coming out that it looked like he's lying.
Yeah.
It makes it look like we all lying.
You know? Yeah,
right, word. Just giving them that right. Somebody right. To jump on us.
I mean, I do think he's lying though.
So you do? Yeah.
Why?
So you do think he's lying?
I think it is somewhat of a publicity stunt.
Like the way the story
is. But when you do look at the facts, whether it's a lie or not, it does make you think politically about certain elements, you know, like the MAGA or the noose or the bleach and it being a hate crime. It makes you think of those components in a political way. But realistically, do I think it happened? From the minute I heard this story, something didn't add up. I'm like, man, you know, like we don't get no pictures, we ain't heard from you.
But I mean, if it's an investigation, even if it was just regular civilized people, you couldn't walk up to an officer and be like, oh yeah, show me the text messages.
That's a fact.
It's an investigation right now. Like, it's.
Oh, so you're saying we can't see none?
I mean, honestly, unless the investigation is open, still, we can't really request anything from the police because they could give away their actual target.
So basically,
because the two guys were let go, right? The two guys that they brought in, they were let go.
The two African guys?
Yeah, they were let go.
So basically, more will be determined. Pretty much.
If I see any holes in your story, that's when I'm like, okay, it's not adding up.
So we speaking about publicity stunts. Publicity, excuse me. What's y'all think about 6ix9ine? Everything that's going on. Like,
people were crazy.
Yeah, he wild.
That nigga funny.
We don't do them rats.
But look, he can get off.
Big finesse.
Yeah, but I mean,
what's the game? Totally. What's getting on? You can't come out here. You know what I mean? You can't even be. You gotta go on a whip.
My thing is though, like the people, the street niggas, and I'm not street at all. I just want everybody to know.
If I was in the street,
I wouldn't even have him be privy to certain things that I'm doing.
He was in the street, nigga, from jump. Yo, they knew that.
That's what I'm saying.
I think he came with a bag to the blood.
He came with a bag. Look, exactly.
I need to get on.
He came with a bag.
Y'all got my back tight,
That's crazy. I get that part though, but like, if he give you a bag, it's like, all right, we got your back. You stay out there, though. We're not going to involve you in everything that you're doing, if that's the case.
I wouldn't let him get that close. But you know how a nigga do, bro. He started getting millions of views. You still, that shit blow your head up. Like, I paid this bread up. I'm this nigga now. I want to see how you cut me on this. You going to do this to me? You know what I mean? That's why niggas was in the back seat smacking him up while he was sleeping. Like, you know what I mean? You don't do that if you're well respected.
Word.
You know what I mean? Everybody won't do that from yourself if you well respected. Like, obviously, me niggas wasn't respected and shit like that.
You playing with that nigga.
Exactly.
Niggas a pawn for them, nigga.
Exactly.
I guess they was a pawn for them. So,
exactly.
But the shit just went left. Like,
and now he out here snitching shit.
Like, real snitching, like.
I mean,
they said he's cooperating. No, they said
that's what snitching is.
I'm snitching.
Listen, I feel like if
you know what the fuck you getting yourself into. Oh, then at the end of the day, if you get caught, my nigga, then you get caught. Ain't no telling, ain't none of that shit. You knew what you was doing from jump, nigga. Like, why you gonna put everybody else in this
but
shit?
But you can't play that game and then be scared when the consequences come. You can't be like, I'm about this, and then, oh shit, I don't really want this that bad. Like, you know what I mean? Like,
yeah, but at the beginning, they knew that he didn't have the same morals as them from the beginning.
That's a fact.
So
I wouldn't even put him in, like,
that's okay. We don't vote for that, bro.
So you can't even blame him.
What does it say about people that support his music and that had supported his music from jump scare? Like, how did they?
I mean, you got some just lit ass individuals, I feel like.
Yeah, so you gotta look at the demographic too of like his fan base. You know what I'm saying? Like, if you look at it, it's more so like the young college kids, white college kids.
So we don't know nothing about his life. We just go, he's respected, he turned up, I like it.
Yeah, yeah. The music just goes to it.
You guys talk about like him being fraudulent or him just being like a bad example, because all rappers got they shit.
I mean, true. That's a fact.
But it, at the same time, you gotta think like so many people had, regardless if you personally supported him or not, he had fan bases. He had some love shows.
Word.
So that fan base that was obviously easily accessible to him is now just open to the next dumbass that might come through and make music and artists a joke.
So y'all feel like,
honestly,
go ahead,
keep it a band with you. I think 6ix9ine was set for the mic. Because I think what they're trying to do, I think they're trying to take that hip hop. Because if you don't remember, like a couple months ago, probably like a year ago, we had like five in the top rappers were all not black. You know what I mean? Like Russ, 6ix9ine,
Post Malone,
like all these other people, like Lil Pete, Lil Fan,
setting
Lil
up the building.
Like, exactly, you know, climbing, those biggest shows, biggest names. But you honest, those people that have no talent, they really get fired. I think what it was is some rich white people. I need to make sure we control hip hop.
You don't think Russ has talent?
I'm not saying they got talent, I'm saying, think about how quickly
he reached the top versus somebody else who may have
been better. But think about it, if you run every country, right? You see hip hop get out of control, you see black people starting to stand up for stuff, they start to realize who they are, they might take over my shit. Alright, I need to put somebody who they're gonna listen to who will fuck up how they're thinking about themselves right now.
Or take a moment and pause their regular lives.
Y'all ain't see just a month ago, Joey Badass had tweeted, yo, all rappers be safe. You know what I'm saying? They got a rapper agenda out here.
They do.
After that shit, you know what I'm saying? I don't know his case, but after that, you know what I'm saying?
YNW Melly.
You know what I'm saying? All that. So it's like, it's looking crazy. Like, is this really the conspiracy on this,
bro? You know what I'm saying? You gotta think of it like this, bro. Like, we can only look at it from the position of the people who are consumers.
That's a fact.
You're not looking at it from the people who are in the position of their power, like the people who are controlling
Word.
Like, because every move they make, they have a specific plan for every move they make. They're not stupid, bro. They're not underthinking.
They've been doing this for years, right? Decades. Like, how was they doing the Motown folks? You know what I'm saying? Like, back then, grind. So it's like generations of the systematic oppression of the artists, the black artists especially. Well, they don't even make that much money. Do you actually know that these artists that are big, they're not making any bread.
Exactly.
They still got to piece out to everybody.
Unless they own their own shit.
Unless they are in charge of their own company, the CEO of their own self, don't have any management team, no marketing promotions. That rapper is broke.
Word.
The influence that they have. You're walking around with the same amount of money in your pocket as me. Why am I looking up to you?
Word. That's a fact. And most of them don't even own their masters, none of that.
Right.
So, like, they own nothing.
You're dropping entire albums with YouTube views.
They built their brand alone. They built their brand up alone.
Word.
They're gonna have to pay it back.
And sometimes none of them can pay it back. Right. They're not getting it back.
And that's why you look at when you get those people who got one album and they don't hear them.
You don't hear them no more.
You're not gonna play because you said one. I'm gonna get a job.
Then they hate the label.
That's how it goes.
Hate the label.
I hate the label.
Oh, you ain't pay that bread back.
You ain't read your contract, girl. You ain't take the time.
Niggas
put a stack of cash in front of you, said sign right, you like, you know what? I'm gonna sign this motherfucker, I don't care what it say. Like, and that's how it goes.
Shit, wow.
That's how it goes.
Right.
It's business though.
Superman.
Yeah.
But yeah, so
just you guys just basically were just talking about how, you know, it's an agenda in hip hop. Do you think, like, you know what just happened with Gucci, you know, that situation? Floyd Mayweather just posted those two, the IG post, and was just basically saying, y'all up front, this is an agenda just to get playing with black people's emotions.
It is. Oh, it is. People don't just like the H&M joint. Just like, they know how to control our us. Like, they know if they are moving.
That Montclair coat was crazy. Huh? Montclair coat was crazy. The Montclair coat.
You're talking about Montclair.
Nah. did you see the Montclair coat with the black faces on Montclair? Yeah, you gotta see that.
I mean, is it hard to you because you're black?
What?
Like, so with the black faces or like, how is it acceptable to you? It's acceptable for you to wear because it's your oppression, your expression.
But look, bro, look. The only reason that holds power, is because we believe it does.
Not hard,
But Floyd's actually, in reality, Floyd's actually doing the right thing. Because if you don't let that bother you and you still, all right, fuck, I don't care what you do, they're gonna be like, oh, they're gonna be shook. Like, damn, my tactics ain't working right now.
Right.
We gotta expose, like, then the next move is gonna be a little bigger, they're gonna expose themselves, they're gonna overstep. But like, every little thing that they do, it's like when your little brother picking with you, or your big brother picking with you. If you ignore him, he go away. But as soon as he's like, stop, oh my gosh, he's like, oh yeah, I got your ass. You playing you, I got you under my thumb now. You
know? And I do think they do that with our community specifically. Really just trying to play with our emotions and just like throw something out there. How many of them can we get to rally behind this and push our agenda for?
And then it makes us look stupid when we rally for a couple months and then we back, like,
We supposed to boycott the Super Bowl this year, right?
Yeah.
I mean, how many of y'all watch the Super Bowl?
I don't watch football at all.
I ain't watch the Super Bowl.
I ain't watched one game in like 2-3 years, bro.
I ain't gonna lie. I watched none of the season, but I watched the Super Bowl.
I just don't like
I ain't watch shit.
I respect that.
I ain't even watch the Super Bowl.
I respect that. But most niggas did.
I was working on music. They already paid.
You heard that.
They already paid. That's how I thought about that shit too. Like, where the fuck I'm gonna go on my way? You know what I'm saying?
You
already paid. You know what I'm saying? I'm trying to get my bag in.
That's a fact. You know what I'm saying? That's a fact as well.
Plus, I don't know what to stand for. So.
All right, but look, the Gucci blackface thing.
Yeah.
All right. So, because I do work in the fashion industry, I mean, you can come find some of my fit. Like, I got a fit, and you know, it's pretty, like, it's working pretty well. But like, with the whole blackface thing. You know, I hate to be the one to say it, but I feel like sometimes we too sensitive as a generation.
We need to stop being sensitive.
We need to see stuff like that and, of course, expose it as a thing, but not take complete personal offense to it. When we take a complete personal offense to it, we shut down the possibility of change.
We
have to see what they're giving us and use it to our power to make a difference.
Talk to them. You know what I'm saying? You gotta speak to people. You know what I'm saying? Because sometimes people don't know. You know what I'm saying? I've been in situations where people were ignorant and they asked me some ignorant ass questions.
True,
and sometimes I'm looking at them like, what the fuck? But then I gotta snap back like, oh, they really don't know.
Really
like,
don't know.
Like, they really asking me this because they don't know. Yeah. So let me answer this in the best way possible.
So they are able
not
to
try
ask,
to like go off
later.
Or nothing like that. Yeah, right.
You gotta think, like, as a kid, like, we supposed to be kids and queens. We can't let little petty shit get us off. You know what I mean? We supposed to be, you said something about blackface, and you're like, oh my gosh, fuck. Like, we said something about white people, they like, niggers.
Yeah.
And keep pushing. That's how we gotta be like, okay, y'all funny. Word. We still got our agenda too. Like, you're not about to derail us off some petty shit. Like,
so,
you know what I mean?
Speaking of, so we have to go back to blackface and minstrel shows and really talk about that and what that means. And to me, like, I've sat and watched them.
Yeah.
And it's
they're crazy.
Man, they're super ignorant.
Yeah,
it's like
bro.
A white person trying to portray the black person as the laziest, dumbest piece of shit. Just
everything.
But is that because of the rising as
that's the thing.
A collective?
I don't think minstrels are I think it's a prime example of how white people really view themselves and the oppression they try to push on.
Well, I don't think we should say white people. I think we should say people who
those people, you, yeah. Those people that entertain that or produce that.
There's other cultures that
are ignorant. Right, for sure. But are the oppressors or the elite or whatever we want to call it, whatever we want to put the name on, but the people that were doing the menstruals and dressing up like black people is because they wanted to be black.
It's because it's a form of flattery.
Exactly.
In real life, that's how we are. Yes.
Because
we start living like that, we take over.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? Like, if you start laughing at them like that, yeah, you're right. That is not funny.
People
now,
do petty things
do?
When they
you know what I mean? That's a different, that's a power, that's a position of power.
Word.
Rather than, oh my gosh, stop doing this to us.
Yeah.
Looking for it, and then we look to our oppressors for the answers of how to stop being oppressed.
Yeah.
How does that work?
Yo.
That's like me chaining you up and you saying, hey, how do I get this key out? And me be like, run around the block 3 times, do a handstand, do a backflip, and I think it's over there across the street. This shit in my pocket.
Word.
You know what I mean?
Yeah.
But I just want to see you do all this stuff, and now you can distract your thing that I have to do.
Yeah.
You feel me? Like, you can't lock me down on that. And then you sit here and I'm asking you, don't have, you know what I mean? Like,
that's not how this is
just going to blow over. Like, every time something like this happens, we just let it blow over.
Exactly.
We always say something. Look, you can say this. Parking shooting. Actually, the year ago was this past week. The parking shooting in Florida. You guys recall?
Yep.
The March for Our Lives, all that. We just let that go. And then the next attack will happen, and we're going to have completely... We're gonna act completely ignorant like it's never happened before.
Yeah.
We need to continue to hold this history to people's agenda. Like, when you're making these next moves to progress, you need to make sure you remember that we've been through this.
Word.
We've been through this.
Word.
Like, we are the generation of 9/11,
word.
Of school shootings.
Word.
Columbine happened in the 90s. I know how y'all remember. Like, there are so many bigger issues that we're just letting slide and not saying anything about afterwards.
Word.
So if blackface is an issue, we need to be on that until the end of the day. Mm-hmm. You can't be like, oh yeah, blackface is an issue. Oh, but look at Cardi B's new shoes.
Yeah,
like,
that's a big fact. That is a big
It's all a distraction. They give you this piece of knowledge to let you know about what's going on in the world, and they give you bullshit that you're gonna read.
Tons of bullshit
to follow up this really important thing you might need to know about your life.
But
you might need to know that your president put the entire nation is in a national emergency.
Word.
And they tell you
that. Yep, they tell you that, and then put a whole bunch of bullshit. So it's like, you know that, but you're not gonna last on the.
But Cardi B got Grammy, so that's what matters. Yeah. We don't need to worry about the national emergency.
So when you bring it up the second time, it's like you already knew about it. So why are you tripping?
Right.
You know what I mean?
So what do y'all feel about the wall?
Okay, I think it's just a flex. I think it's. I mean, honestly, that portion that's going to keep people out. We are surrounded by water.
Well,
half the time people are going to If there's a wall, there's 8 other ways to get around it. You can get under. You can go over. You can go around it.
But honestly, bro, what's that wall that keep people out?
The wall is keeping us in.
I think Trump just
Hey, but listen,
it's dumb.
People voted for him.
They did.
We cannot be upset. We can.
The thing is,
I don't vote.
See, listen,
it's a system.
The system is built. But you have to use the little pawns. It's not about the big election. It's about the little ones.
Who are the
Senate, the House of Representatives, who we're saying is okay to be in our judiciary branch.
But who's behind them though? That's what I'm saying.
But,
exactly.
But we can't be those. We
That's part of the
we regular
campaign.
People can run. You have your own clout to do stuff like that. If you want to change, you gotta make that shit. That's the generation we're in.
2022
legally.
2022. DTV will be representing somebody who's running for the mayor of DC. So we are making changes out here.
Yeah,
so we're all the way
involved. We have to be involved.
I'm gonna get my man's tomorrow for the presidency of the United States one day. You know what I'm saying? So we gonna change all this shit. Don't worry about it. DTV on the way.
Yo, on the lower levels, like the mayors and all that, that's cool. I understand, like, someone brought it to my attention about how you do have to vote for the lower levels because that's where the real change in the communities and amongst us occurs.
Word.
So that was brought to my attention, but vote for the president and all that, that's the shit I feel like we will never win at.
Hey, look, okay, look, to piggyback off what you just
said. That's our government. Now, look, y'all gotta know the truth about it. 9/11, that's an inside job. Come on, our government is not for the people.
Look, to piggyback off what you just said, right? If we got all these mayors and whatever who are representing the right thing, it don't matter if the president is saying something, but everybody under him is disagreeing.
He can't do anything. He has no power.
He's only a powerful man if everybody believes he's a powerful man. Mm-hmm. You know what I mean? But who's actually in power under him is like, man, fuck what you're saying. We're not doing that. Yeah. And they stick together, then it don't matter. You know what I'm saying? Like, that's what you do. I take over the local markets, the local governments, the local
word.
You know what I mean? If we can start getting to those offices, start affecting change locally in pockets. It matters because when that big word comes, if that big word don't come all the way down to the individual small people, then if it stop all the way up here and then a different word start down here, you know what I mean?
That's a finite. That's what's going on with that wall now. He's in his own party, so I just think, I don't know, but it's just, I'm funny about politics because
it's a fucked up situation.
Yeah, like, it's like, you got that side over there with Trump, like, you know what they represent. But I feel like the other side just plays with our emotions, like we were talking about earlier, and tries to rile us up behind these causes that really don't care about. They just want our vote, and nothing changes.
But there are people who care about it. But we have the first bisexual person to enter Congress.
But that's how they do it.
We have representation. We need to utilize it.
Look, that's how they do it, though. They do some fucked up shit to us. And then turn around and give us a black woman. Or give us a black and then raise us up for a little bit. They bring all of them around and then they're the ones to bring us back up. It's like Dave Chappelle. You see Dave Chappelle's special? We talking about the pimp? He's the one to beat her up and then we want to build her back up. And then the girl don't know which one he is. Like, he gets smacked up and be like, nah, baby, I love you. You know what I'm saying? It's the same thing. That's what they're doing. They beating us the fuck up.
So it's psychological warfare against their own civilization.
Exactly.
Yeah.
That's what y'all gotta see, man.
It's
bigger than the little things. It's big, big moves. They playing chess. You hear me? With Chinese checkers. they're not playing no game, though. That's why I feel like that's just kind of goes back to like what we do and why we do what we do. You know what I mean? That's why we own what we own. That's why we make revenue in ways that have nothing to do with music. And then plus,
but the crazy part about it is like when we do own, we don't support. You know what I'm saying? So look, going back to like the Gucci shit, right? So we got G-Unit, Fat Farm, what was it, FUBU, all these lines, they were black owned lines. What happened to them? They weren't cool enough.
You wonder why, though?
You know what I'm saying?
You wonder why,
they weren't dope enough to wear.
That's not even why. It's not because it wasn't dope enough. It's because our music and our culture talks about fuck another nigga. I'm about the catch another nigga. It's all about my success, my success,
and the brands that they're wearing.
So then when I'm around my other black people who I don't know, I think I have to be what I just heard because that's what they're expecting of me.
So
I
can't really wear the Louis, the Fendi, the Gucci.
And then because I'm not worried about your success because I'm worried about if you're gonna succeed, that means I can't succeed because not so many black people can succeed. So I have to make sure that you don't, so I can't. Rather than saying nah, we about to all do this. There's enough success to go around.
If you look at other cultures, like
there's enough success to go around.
They all like predominantly stick together, and when they stick together, what happens?
They're good.
Everybody eats, you know what I'm saying? The platform is set, you know what I mean?
Yep.
This one handles this one handles that, you know what I'm saying? Nobody's getting in each other's way, you know what I mean? Nobody's hating on the next man, but they like, yo, how we gonna get this other bag and split that shit? You know what I'm saying? Like, that's a better movement.
Well, I mean, even in nature, strength comes in numbers.
Yeah, word. Facts.
But we as a community, like he was saying, we break each other down in order to get up.
Yeah.
You see it in females, you see it in little kids.
Yeah.
No, you're dumb. No, you're dumb. I'm better than you because you're dumb. Or, oh no, I'm skinny and you are whatever you want to call that.
Word.
That body type, that's
you
not
what you
want. So why do you think the black community in general is more susceptible to breaking each other down than other communities. Why?
Because we were taught to be that way.
Yeah, it was taught.
No,
it was
taught. No, listen, I got you.
That shit was definitely taught.
Racism is taught. Hatred is taught. How you treat each other is taught. How your parents treated you, how their parents treated them, how the people around them and their generation treated them, that affects how you talk to people in humanity for the rest of your life.
Right.
So you're telling me if I grew up knowing I'm black and white, on my black side, they're not going to support me because I'm white. On my white side, they're not going to support me because I'm black. You have all of these sides that are always going against you as you're growing up, and then when you get to the top and become an adult, you're like, whoa, I've been broken down my whole life, so now I gotta break somebody else down so I can get up. Yeah, because that's how everyone else around me has risen. Life. You broke me down, you told me I wasn't shit. You told me I wasn't going anywhere. So that way you can
each other. So y'all talking about slavery starting with us, y'all was selling in Africa, everyone was brown or black, the most majority back then.
At least it was equal that they were selling each other.
Exactly.
It was forced selling. It was like, you want to live? Alright, show them where everybody else at.
Exactly. You know, and then you're like showing them a different tribe. Yeah, you don't even fuck with them. They speak a different tongue. You like, okay, bet. If you want to
So thank you for tuning in to On the Run TV and you can catch us every Thursday. Here we out. Time.